fifth graders, I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the AIMS test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is solving two-step equations with algebra. Sometimes we can solve algebra problems with inverse operations. Here's an example problem. The soccer club is going on a trip to the water park. The cost of attending the trip is $23.
Included in that price is $3 for lunch and the cost of two identical wristbands, one for the morning and one for the afternoon.
Write an equation representing the cost of the field trip and determine the price of one wristband.
Algebra in elementary school? Inverse operations? This could be tricky. Let's bring in Jonah, our insightful math vocabulary person, to help us understand algebra, variables, and inverse operations.
Thank you, Alexis. Let's not panic because Trent said the A word. Algebra is simply a branch of mathematics where we use letters or variables to represent unknown values. Heck, we use boxes in first grade to find unknown numbers, so basic algebra is not any different. We just use a letter instead of a box. Inverse means opposite, so inverse operations are opposite operations. The opposite of addition is subtraction, and the opposite of multiplication is division. So in some situations, we use inverse operations to solve algebra equations. Let's solve the water park problem. Writing an algebra equation is the first step. We write 2w plus 3 equals $23, with w representing the cost of one wristband. So we subtract 3 from both sides of the equation. After we subtract 3 from both sides, our new equation reads 2w equals 20. 2w means 2 multiplied by w. Time to use another inverse operation. Let's divide both sides by 2, since division is the inverse of multiplication. After we divide, we get w equals 10. 10 buckaroos for each wristband. Now back to Trent.
Thanks, Jonah. The best way to learn how to solve two-step equations with algebra is to practice. Alexis, do you have another two-stepper to solve?
I certainly do. Trudy paid $20 for a concert ticket. She bought 3 lemonades at the concert. The total cost of the concert was $32. How much for each lemonade?
I'll use the letter A as the cost of lemonade. Okay, boys and girls, what would you write for an algebraic equation? 3A plus 20 equals 32 would work.
Now it is time for inverse operations. What would you do first? I'm going to subtract 20 from both sides of the equation. Now we have 3a equals 12. What do we do next? Divide both sides by 3.
Using a fraction bar with a 3 below the bar is one way to divide. Our final answer is a equals 4.
One lemonade costs $4. We can check our answer by substituting the A with $4. Look, it works. We solved a two-step algebra problem. I love using inverse operations.
Thank you for watching this video. What's the big idea? Solving two-step equations with algebra.
Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks. For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the Big Idea?